With this stupid tutorial, I want to teach you an amazing animation technique where you can make any element repeatedly grow and shrink in front of you to make kind of like a background feeling or a prolonged animation which will stay until the end of the slide. I want to click on the picture, and from the animations, once I open them, I want to select the grow shrink. Nothing unusual, right? By default, as you can see, if I play it from by having the animation pane opened, the grow shrink is super fast and looks very weird. So I'll double click on it. I go to the effects panel, and we can notice we have the size of 150%. I'll reduce the size just to 105%, and I need to click enter here. Clicking enter means this setting will be saved. Alright, so currently, once I click my mouse, I have an animation like that. A slow grow, but I'm not sure how long I will explain this slide. So, should I make this animation 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 4 seconds, or longer? Now, that's the key question. You have a couple of tricks how you can make this animation to be seamless, looping, and looking amazing. I'll double click again and use the basic PowerPoint features. At first, I want to make the animation to play until the end of this slide. Alright, so the animation will now repeat infinitely. Let me reduce it to 3 seconds so it's quicker for preview. Currently, once I click my mouse, you see the picture is growing and it starts to grow again because the animation is repeating until the end of the world. That's a solid start. This was the first adjustment. The second adjustment, normally you would do it all at once, but I want to show you the process of doing this. So we have repeated the animation until the end of the slide. We can also go to effects, and what's cool, we can auto reverse. What does this option change? This option makes that within the 3 seconds when the animation is played, it will both grow and shrink back. So during the 3 seconds, it will always grow, shrink, grow, shrink. As you can see, the animation is no longer because it needs 6 seconds now. It grows for 3 seconds and it makes itself smaller for 3 seconds. The problem here is the motion in which it bounces back is very static. So in order to adjust this, I'll show this to you on a shorter duration. The way to adjust this is to double click, go to effects, and give it a smooth start and smooth end. What this will do, the animation will start a little slower, and at the very end, when it becomes like the biggest and the smallest, it will stop for a brief moment, or it will get a bit slower. Currently, we have the animation adjusted. So with a simple grow shrink animation, by giving it repeat until end of slide, auto reverse, and a bit of smooth start and end, we've adjusted this animation to become something like that. Once we click, you can see this image is really pulsing. It's pulsing very smoothly because we have the bounce beginning and the bounce end. And of course, right now it's like too intensive for the viewer, but you get the idea. You can always make the duration longer. This way, it would take 6 seconds to play back and forth, and you would have a very pleasant effect on the back of your slide while explaining something. It doesn't have to be a mountain, you got it right. It can be even a different picture. This will be always a very clever and useful PowerPoint trick to remember.